Tim and I have been talking about him coming back, and coming back on a monthly basis, like a Sunday night, Monday. And so we're getting that set up. But I believe he just has something that is depositing. He's depositing into our church, into our lives, and I just want to be a part of what God is doing. Let's give Brother Tim Story a great big hand as he comes tonight.
Let's stand up and let's give the Lord a big clap. Come on. Come on, Kentucky. We're more than good basketball teams. Just the piano sound. You're just playing the piano sound. Lift your hands towards heaven. Thank you, Father, for what you're doing. Hands lifted. Look at that presence. Woo! Say, I receive my miracle. In Jesus' name. You know, the Lord is already moving. Let's get some people healed real quick. This man, the tall man in the second row, who's the lady next to you on your right? Come and get healed quick, but come real quick. There's a reason for quick. Somebody clap like it's working tonight. Will you hold hands with him? Hold hands. Come quicker. Take two steps back. One, two, one, two, one, two. Bam. See how that power just went right through you? See that power just went right through you? See that power? Miss, his heart is being healed. I said his heart. Am I right, miss? How would I know that unless I'm flowing pretty heavy in the gifts? The man in the white sweater, run. Your miracle just hit you, but come quicker. Stand there, it hits you sideways. Bam, it just hits you sideways. I'm going to flow real heavy tonight because I'm in the mood. Somebody clap your hands and shout like God's powerful. Come on, clap like God's a miracle working God. Come on, now we got you warmed up. Let's go get it. Come on, let's take back what the devil stole from this area. My usher with the maroon coat, come quick. All through your bones you're being healed. Your legs being healed. Pick your knees up now. Pick your knee up. Pick your knee up. Is that amazing? Come here. What's that feel like? And your ears are still opening. Look at me. Boom, 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 boom. What's that feeling like? Charles, what's happening to your ears? They're opened. I'm in a very heavy gift. A tall man, you're going to get a lot of money. You're way in the back row. I'd run, brother, if someone said that. Even if you don't think you're tall, I would run. I'd go even faster than that. I would pick up the pace. I would quickly take the... Just take the whole thing. See. You may be seated. Come here. As soon as you hit that spot, you're healed. See? Boom. Right through you. Right through you. Boom. Explain.
It's a feeling that's unbelievable. Oh, Jesus. It goes from the top of your head to the bottom of your feet. It's all through your whole body. You can feel the glory of Jesus.
Move your wrists. How awesome does that feel? Huh? How would I have known about that? We're just doing some Jesus work. He went about doing good. Somebody clap your hands like God's powerful. Come on and clap. Bring her. She got healed. Come on. I got to go. I got to do a quick work tonight because someone's going to Israel. Tell them what it felt like when you walked up here.
Oh my God. It's, I don't know, electrifying. It's, I have no words. It's just electrifying.
How would I know that your blood is getting healed? And that you get tired at 2 and 3 in the afternoon and now your blood is being healed. And how would I know that God is resurrecting your family? And the Lord said that to you, that your family would all come back. And the Lord says they're coming from the north, the south, the east, and the west. And how would I know that your hip just got healed? Bam! Somebody give the Lord a clap and a shout. Come on and stir me up, Kentucky. Come on, Kentucky. Come on, stir me up like God is powerful. Somebody shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Your God is an awesome God. He's a mighty God. He's a powerful God. Bring her up. She just got healed. I'm in a heavy gift. I'm a God man. I'm not the healer. Jesus is the healer. Joel Osteen's not the healer. Come on, Marilyn Hickey's not the healer. Pastor Bob Rogers not the healer. Jesus is the healer. Give the Lord a clap like Jesus is the healer. You got a good-looking son. Walk around. You got a good-looking son. Pick your legs up for me now. Look how free. I'm in a deep gift. It feels like when I'm overseas, like in Brazil or Bogota, Colombia. I'm in a heavy gift. Somebody's been interceding in Kentucky. Somebody clap your hands like you're ready to take back what the enemy took. Come here. Tell me how that feels on your legs. You feel a... Tell the people.
I feel a warmth and a healing that's happening in my knees. Hallelujah. Some of you know that the other night he called us up and he just reached out his hand like that. And we went down and I felt it's just like a wave, a gentle wave hit us. And as I laid there on the floor, God was doing a miracle in me. I went home and passed a stone that was impossible to pass in the natural. God healed me. Thank you for it. Praise God. Thank you.
Bam, you just opened your ears. Bam, you're going to live a long life. Long, long, long and strong. Somebody clap your hands. Somebody shout. Come on, Kentucky. Somebody clap like God's powerful. Somebody shout unto God. This feels. In the 90s, there was a series of time when I went to Billy Joe Doherty's almost every month, and the glory hit at Billy Joe Doherty's, and I was camped out there, and I was at Oral Roberts University nonstop. I probably went there probably 27 times in 4 years. There is a move of God taking place in this part of the country. I need everybody to stand up, and I want you to stand up like you've got some energy to stand up. And somebody give the Lord a clap and a shout like he is moving. Come on, somebody. Come on, stir it up. Somebody shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Shout unto God. Lift your hand. Somebody say, Jesus is healing us. I need that person that you can hardly breathe right now to run to the front. But you're not coming up here foolishly. You're coming up here desperately. Stand there. There's another person. You can hardly breathe. Run. I'm in an incredible gift. Now come. You're not coming up here with silliness. You're coming up here to get healed. You can hardly breathe. You got a breathing problem. Run to the front. I got another breathing problem. Breathing, respiratory. Come to the front. That's him. That's him. That's you. You're the one. In Jesus' name. Somebody shout like God's powerful. Somebody shout unto God. Come on, bring it out of me like Oral Roberts used to. Somebody shout in the spirit. It's all being lifted. I said it's all being lifted off you. I said it's all being lifted off you. You're going to become a new person. Pick up your legs and walk strong now. Don't make me pull you. Walk strong. Walk like you're free. Lift your hands like you're free. Somebody clap your hands like she's getting free. Oh, Rebekesha, Rabba Rebekesha. Come on, America. Come on, let's catch up with the rest of the world. And let's start flowing in the power of Jehovah. Is that amazing? Huh? Is that amazing? Look at me. Is that amazing? I'm not a normal preacher. I'm sorry. I don't do normal. Come here, come here, come here, come here. Run, 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 run. Your blood just got healed. It went through your blood. It went through her blood. Someone has ringing in their ears, but it's terrible. It rings so loud, it's driving you nuts. Run to the front. Man, there's an anointing in this place. I'm just stepping into the river that's already here. The ringing in your ears. If I was you, I would jump over somebody. The ringing in your ears. Somebody clap your hands like God's powerful. Run up here. Through you, sideways, 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 sideways. Somebody clap your hands. It hits that way, that way, that way. Somebody shout like he's powerful. Slava Bogu. Pick him up. I'm in a zone right now. I'm in an overseas zone. Pick him up. You feel that? What's happening? Yeah, it's leaving. Let's fix your eyes. That's what they say I'm good at. In the area of eyes. It's what?
Getting clear.
It's what?
Getting.
It's getting clearer. Clear. It's getting. Somebody clap like God can get his eyes better. Somebody shout into. Shout into. Come on, somebody shout into. Somebody. You better. Somebody. Come on, Kentucky. Come on. You got stomach problems, come up here, but they're real bad. Stomach, in the stomach, you should run. Oh, that was wild. You felt it when you came around the corner, you're gonna start crying. The Lord would say unto you,
there is going to be a great impartation of the Holy Spirit. And beginning Easter, there's going to be a release. There's going to be a time, of a season for families to be saved. Those situations that you think are impossible, God's beginning to work on it right now. And Easter's going to be an explosion of the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. If you have a family member that impossible for them to get saved, it'd be a miracle for them to get saved, raise your hand right now. It was a miracle when you got saved. And it's going to be a miracle. They're going to come to Christ in the name of Jesus. Hold your hand up high. Father, this is our season. This is a season for great signs and wonders in our home and a visitation with our sons and our daughters and our family members, Lord. And may they come to Christ in Jesus' name for your glory and your honor. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big praise God.
That is awesome. Just keep on clapping. Come on, shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Say this, say, He is a miracle working God. Say, I believe, I expect, I receive. Now reach up and get it again. I receive, pull it down. Watch, you believe it, you receive it. Watch. And then you become a miracle. Peter said, silver and gold have I none. But what I've become, I give you. You believe in miracles, you expect them, you receive them, you become one, and then you begin to become a miracle releaser. The enemy is not afraid of one man who works miracles. But of an army of us. That's what God's doing in this region. Come on, I said an army of us. Housewives and educators. Come on, somebody. And students. Come on, clap your hands and shout. If we begin to work the works of Christ, say believe, expect, receive, say become, release. For Jesus went about doing good. I walked on the American Airlines plane and the flight attendant saw me and she looked away and I noticed she started crying. And I went to the fourth seat, and she came up. She said, I don't mean to bother you, but your name is Tim Story. I said, yes. She said, I used to go to a church, a guy named Casey Treat. I said, he's a good guy. And she said, I've been backslid for about 15 years. But when I saw you walk by, she goes, you reminded me of the person I used to be. Now listen, the anointing breaks the yoke. It's not going to be just one minister, male or female, that we all run to. God is anointing us. God uses shaky people to do sturdy projects. You say, but I went through something in 1967. That's okay. It's 2014 now. Somebody clap your hands and shout. Come on, somebody shout. Come on, shout like it's 2014. Now listen, if you've been feeling unworthy, if you've been feeling shamed, pay attention because I'm on to something tonight. And you just feel like you need God to push the reset button. I want you to run to the front. It's going to be more than half the crowd. You just say, Tim Story, I need God to push the reset button in my life. It's just not going well. Just keep coming. Just keep coming. Just keep. It's going to be at least half the crowd if you're honest. Just keep coming. And just lift your hands towards heaven. Just lift your hands. Just keep on coming. Just keep on coming. Just keep on coming. No straight lines, just keep coming even more. You say, I just have not been doing well. Just come on up here. Just keep coming. It's going to be more than that if you're honest. And I want somebody that's been getting breakthroughs to come and get behind them. You've been getting breakthroughs, just get behind them. Come on, haven't you been getting breakthroughs? There's more room. Someone that's been getting breakthroughs, get behind them, put your hand on their back, and just begin to pray in the Holy Spirit. The man that I prayed for his eyes, come and get your glasses, and you're going to notice as you keep wearing them, your eyes are getting better and better. It's like I said, he said his eyes are getting better and better. Just put them in your pocket. You'll see. Just pray for somebody. Just come put your hands on those people. Just... How long has tall man been coming to church? Miss? How many times has tall man come? Huh? Tall man, look at me. You're a good guy. Close your eyes. Breathe that in. Boom. Take the whole thing, tall man. Boom, it just hits you. 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 They're right behind you. Miss, did you see him go into the power? That's good. Say, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly. The word able means he has the necessary power, skill, or resources. It means he's qualified. To do beyond means superior, surpassing, outside the boundaries, outside the limits. God is about to go beyond your reasoning, beyond your capacity, beyond your capability. You say, I haven't been able. Well, God is going to enable where you've been unable. God lives beyond, he creates beyond, he thinks beyond, he expects beyond. He loves beyond, he forgives beyond, and he restores beyond. I said, God is restoring your family beyond. Somebody clap your hands like God is restoring us beyond. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, clap like he restores beyond. If you've been through something, God is restoring you beyond. Say, he restores beyond. And then watch this. Look at me. He calls beyond. Noah, build me an ark, but I haven't seen rain. Abraham, have me a child, but I'm past the age. He calls beyond. Because he knows that when his super hits your natural, everything becomes supernatural. Last thing I'll do, lift your hands. Close your eyes. Say, Holy Spirit, fill me once again with supernatural power to go beyond, to live beyond, to restore beyond. Here he comes. Close your eyes. Just stay in this. Stay in it. I want to hear you begin to sing in the spirit like we used to in the 70s. Pastor Bob, we'd be at Meliland Christian Center. We'd just be singing in the spirit. Come on, somebody sing in the Holy Ghost. I want to hear you sing in the Holy Ghost. Rebeke sharebeke sharabarababu rebeke sharabaka.
To the Lord. Praise God. This past week, I was sharing some of this morning. I had a real encounter with the Lord, and I began to see gold dropping. And it was like gold strands begin to drop on my... It wasn't gold dust. Years ago, I was in China, and I was having breakfast and with Benny Hinn, and we began to talk about gold dust, and he had a doctor there that manifestation had happened, and where this gold flakes would come on people. I thought to myself, well, what in the world does that mean? I mean, that it's a sign and a wonder. It does. If you did see gold on people, that would make you wonder, wouldn't it? Well, we were riding a chairlift up to the Great Wall of China. And this doctor was talking to me about this gold dust. And so we just began to praise the Lord. And all of a sudden, that gold dust came on me. I never had that happen. I thought, well, man, I wish I could scrape this off and cash it in. But I began to see these drops of gold. And actually, I thought it was the air conditioning leaking. And I'm thinking, it's ruining my coat. And I kept brushing my coat. And this fellow sat next to me, kept looking at me. And then I began to see these streaks of gold. And sometimes they would go in circles. And they would begin to fall. And I thought I was going blind. I thought there's something wrong with my eye. And so I called a doctor. And I began to explain. They said, no. I said, but I do think you ought to get your eyes checked. And so I went to see a doctor, but they began to explain that's not something in your eye. And I began to realize it was a manifestation of the Holy Spirit. I've never had anything like that, but I really feel like the Lord has spoken to me that this is the time of a beginning of God's anointing and God's supernatural flow of prosperity and blessings upon our lives. And I believe that you're living in a moment of the Holy Spirit where God is going to visit you. And I don't mean to sound spooky or weird, but I'm just telling you that God sometimes moves in strange ways. And that's why they're called signs and wonders, because it really causes you to wonder what's happening. But this is a time that I believe God is going to open doors that have never been opened to you before. I'll give to you the key of David. And the doors I open, no man will shut. And the doors that I shut, no man will open. And it says, repent. And it says, be converted, for the times of the refreshing will come. And I believe we're entering into that time of refreshing, that time of a fresh anointing. And with that anointing always comes increase and blessing in the name of the Lord. If you need a blessing, hold your hands up now. Just begin to thank God right now for the blessing of the Lord. The Bible says the blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich, and he addeth no sorrow with it. Father, I thank you for the blessing of God. I thank you, Lord, for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Oh, there it is. It's beginning to fall right now. I sense there's a blessing falling upon the people of God right now. Let's just begin to thank God for it in advance. Father, I thank you for the blessing coming upon our lives, upon our homes, upon our thought patterns, our businesses, upon our future in the name of the Lord. And Father, we declare your kingdom come and your will be done in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I want you to reach over and join the hand of someone on either side of you. Join hands with those on your right and those on your left. And I want us to pray this prayer together out loud. Say, Lord Jesus, cleanse me from all wickedness and all impurities. Take out of me what the devil has put in my life. Take it out of me now. May I have a clean heart and a pure mind. In Jesus' name, fill me with your love. May there be no prejudice or racism or injustice in my life, but fill me with the presence of the Holy Ghost. Now, devil, take your hands off my family. I declare to you, we're not in trouble. You're the one who's in trouble, because I'm anointed with the power of the Holy Spirit. I shall do whatever God has called me to do. I call the money in from the north, the south, from the east and the west. There'll be plenty of money to do what God's called us to do. I bless those now on my right. Be filled with the presence of the Lord. May your life be strong for God. I bless you on the left of me. May this be a season of prosperity, a season where God speaks to you. I bless those in front of me and in back of me. May good things happen. Even in the next 7 days, may good things happen to you. Now lift your hands up to the Lord. I want you to just begin to praise him out loud. The effectual fervent prayer is an out loud prayer. It's not a silent prayer, it's an out loud prayer. Come on, begin to praise him in the Holy Ghost. Begin to worship in your prayer language. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lord. 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 Oh, bo 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 ko yata la ta bo ko yata la bo ko. Ki bi yandara de bo ko yata la bo ko yata la bo ko. Hallelujah. You know, I sense something very strange. I've never said this before, but I really sense this by the Holy Spirit. You know, there's a real wonderful presence of the Holy Spirit, and that anointing that's on Brother Tim's story for healing and for the word of knowledge and for the gifts of healing, I feel is being released here tonight. And many of you are going to begin to sense that same thing even this week at work, with your neighbors, with people over the telephone, with thoughts are going to begin to come to your mind about some friend that you haven't seen in a while, and you're going to text them on your phone, and God's going to heal them as they even read the text in the name of Jesus. But I sense a release of the Holy Ghost here. I sense a release for strong signs and wonders and healings for the glory of God. How many would allow the Lord to heal you, to use you in healing? Can I see? Hold those hands up. The Bible says lifting up holy hands. without wrath and without doubting. Without wrath means you don't hold any grudges. You don't hold any unforgiveness. Without doubting means in full belief and full faith in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, these are holy hands. These aren't ordinary hands, but these are hands anointed to heal the sick and to cast out devils and to proclaim the salvation of Jesus Christ. I loose the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I loose the word of knowledge gift and the word of faith and the anointing to believe God for money. I loose the gifts of healing that heal cancer and diabetes and heart disease. I loose the anointing of the word of knowledge that shows things that have happened and things that will come in the name of Jesus. I loose the gift of prophecy that would encourage and uplift and turn people from depression. I loose that anointing in the name of Jesus. Come on, just say, I receive it, Lord. Come on, say it again. Say it again. Say in the name of Jesus, I receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. Let's give the Lord a great big praise clap tonight. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You may return to your seats in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Maybe you've come here tonight just to try to win a trip to Israel or win one of these dinners we're going to give away. And you've seen all this. Margaret, when she first came to our church, she was a good old Baptist girl, a member of Calvary Baptist in Corbin, Kentucky. And as she came up here for Christmas break, and she came to church, never been in a church like this, and the speaker was E.T. Quanabush. Now, you know he has to be a good speaker to have a name like that. Hallelujah. But God began to do great miracles, and she stood up in the back. She had never seen anything like that. She stood up, and she knew it was God. She had never experienced anything like that, but she knew it was the Lord. And sometimes we see these manifestations, and you've never seen anything like that. Maybe you've come from the Catholic Church or the Baptist Church or a church where there was never any demonstrations of what God can do. You've read about them in the Bible. And sometimes if it's different, sometimes people wonder. But when you see God do what he's done tonight, it should take the wonder out. And by faith, you say, Lord, I want that to happen in my life, in my home, in Jesus' name. I want you to bow your heads right now. If you're here tonight and you say, Pastor Bob, I want that power. I want that anointing. I want the baptism in the Holy Spirit. I want whatever this is, I want it inside of me. Can I just see your hand? Just slip your hand up. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes. Hands are going up. Margaret, come up here just a moment. Hands are going up all over. Hallelujah. How many are here and you say, Pastor, I've been around this, but I've never been used of God to lead people to Christ or get anybody healed, but I want that to start happening. Can I see your hand? I want to see, yes, 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 yes. Well, if you raised your hand, I want you to stand up right now. Just stand up where you are. I'm going to pray for you right where you are. I'm not even going to have you come forward. I'm just going to have right where you're standing. And Margaret, come up here just a minute. I want you to lead in a prayer of release, a release of the Holy Spirit, a release of the power of God. And I want those that are sitting around you, and I want you to just stretch your hands out to them or reach over and touch them in the name of Jesus. Margaret, I want you to lead us in prayer.
You know, the Holy Spirit gives me a word tonight for you, and it's this. And it says, I will come down as showers upon mown grass. I will come down and water you as showers upon mown grass. You know, as we come to a place in our life where we are cut down, maybe you feel like you've been cut to the bone. That's a time for the Holy Spirit that you can open yourself up to Him and receive the greatest blessing and the greatest miracle of your life. And right now, if you need the Holy Spirit, if you need God in a deeper measure, raise your hand. Just raise your hands to Him, those that stand, that are standing. And this is just a sign that, God, I'm putting aside everything around me, and right now my focus is on You. Right now, this isn't a time for you to think of anybody around you or where you're going after you leave here or what's coming in the next few minutes when they roll that thing out here. This is your moment with God, with the Holy Spirit, to touch you and to transform you. And right now, I just want you to pray with me right out loud. You know, I remember when I came to that place in my life as a college student, and I fell at the altar and I felt so empty of myself. That's when the Holy Spirit took over. It began to take out of me everything that Satan had put in me. And He began to fill me up with something fresh and something new and something I'd never seen and something I'd never been. Oh, has that been transforming? That's the life the Holy Spirit has for you. Pray with me right now. Say, Dear Father, I come to You tonight in the name of Jesus. I ask You to forgive me. Forgive me where I've resisted You. Forgive me where I've turned my back. Forgive me where I have not listened, where I have not sought You. Forgive me where I've sinned. Right now, Holy Spirit, I ask You to come into my life and to forgive me and to put me in a new place. Right now, I choose to get off that train I've been on and to allow the Holy Spirit to navigate my life by putting me in the direction that He would have me to go. And so right now, Lord, I receive that refreshing of the Holy Spirit. Now raise your hands across this place. Raise your hands across this plate. And right now, just begin to thank Him. Thank you that He's touching you, that He's ministering to you right now, that He's transforming you. And begin to speak in your prayer language, because there's a release of the Spirit of God over here tonight. Just begin, everyone, to pray in the Holy Spirit. Those of you who have never spoken in tongues, this is your time. Begin to just speak it out loud. It may seem like a little small syllable that begins to well up. Just speak that syllable out, because it'll be a release of the Spirit of God, and the Holy Spirit will begin to speak through you. Makashondre arada siri andre arado sondo. Iradado sondre arada siri andre arada sanda. Kibababasanda. People are receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit right now. I see it on you. Makashababasondre arada siri andre arada sanda. Kiri arado sondre arada siri andre arado sondo. Raise your hands if you're receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit and wave them right now. Just wave them right now. Look around. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord.
Oh, praise the Lord. Come on, let's give the Lord another great big praise clap. This is wonderful. You may be seated tonight. Well, in just a few moments, we're going to have our drawing, and then we're going to give a trip away to Israel. And how many have been praying you'll get that trip? How many have been fasting a little bit you'll get that trip? Well, that trip will be worth probably $3,500 to you. And if you tried to do it without going into a group, it might be worth $5,000 to you, because we're able to get the rates lower when you bring a group. But before we do, we're going to receive a special missions offering for Pastor Tim Story. And I think he deserves an offering, don't you? Don't you think that was good tonight? The ushers have an envelope, and if you have a especially a cash offering and you want to get giving credit, be sure and hold up your hand. President Obama has now issued a bill, I guess it's a bill, that you're capped on how much you can give now to a local church, and it's 28%. And after that, you won't get any tax credit. I don't think it's been passed by the House. But pretty soon, he will reduce that to 20%. and then 10%, and then 0%. And if that's going to affect your giving to God, then hold off on it now. Because I believe that God is able to give back much more than just a tax donation to His people that give to God's work. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
I want you to say with me, I love to give.
I'm excited about giving.
Because every time I give to God, He blesses it back in a greater measure. Now I'm going to ask you tonight to give your best. What is your best? If you have a $1 bill and a $5 bill, what's your best? If you have a $5 bill and a $10 bill, your best is $10. If you have a $20 bill and a $50 bill, your best is your $50 bill. I was in a service with Pastor Keith, and we were in a service, and a minister was preaching, and he got ready to take the offering. He said, I want to give your best. I had a $20 bill and a $50 bill, and I reached it over and leaned next to Pastor Colletti. Rich Colletti had a $100 bill, and I got my 20 out. And he said, I said, Clayton, what are you going to give? He said, I'm going to give my best. I'm going to give $100. I said, what are you going to give? I said, I'm going to give my 20. And that preacher, he said, you know, there's a young man here that has a $20 bill and a $50 bill. And if you will give your best, in 3 days, God will give it back to you. Well, I took that 20 and I stuck it back in my pocket and I got out the 50. And Clady was looking at me. Clady, am I telling the story right? And I gave that $50. 3 days later, I was up in close to Lima, Ohio. And this is the truth. I picked up a hitchhiker. And I was driving down the road, and he said, you can let me off right here. And so I got ready to let him off. He said, I'm supposed to give you this. And he gave me $50. And I've learned that if you give your best, God will give you His best. Amen? How many will give your best tonight? Wave at me if you'll give your best. Hallelujah. All right, if you may have a check, make a check payable to Evangel. And this will all go towards Brother Tim Story and his ministry. Hallelujah. I want you to give you a moment to give your offering ready. You take your offering and hold it up to the Lord. Pray with me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for the ministry of Tim Story. Bless him in abundance. Everywhere he goes, may the favor of God be upon him. Let this offering be more than enough to meet every need. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you as you receive the offering. And I'm going to turn the service here to Pastor Kevin. Hallelujah.
I'm going to give the ushers a moment to finish collecting the offering, and then I'll need their assistance for us to prepare now for this great prize giveaway. But while they're finishing, let me just remind you that as you go out tonight, Brother Tim Story has a lot of great products that you can get, and the cost is extremely reasonable. He offers some opportunity to get some flash drives that contain 12 or more videos, a full book, MP3s. You can get his life coaching series and numerous materials in one little item. He's got a new dream series coming out. You want to get more information about that. He's got numerous other products available. So you don't want to leave yet, but when you do leave, after we're finished, after the trip to Israel's been given away, that's when you'll be ready to go. Not until then, we want to make sure that you stop by and take some of this great teaching home with you. Don't you appreciate that he's invested his life to be used the way he is? Amen. Amen. Praise God. Now, let me explain what we're going to do. Many of you participated in our survey month, and we thank you so very much. You cannot imagine how helpful it is in this day and age in which we live to keep up-to-date, accurate information. And people are so mobile, things change so much, that we have to do this in order to minister to you effectively. So we thank you for doing that. Some of you did not have the opportunity, and so I'm going to ask, here's the way we're going to do this. I'm going to ask the ushers to give everyone a form tonight. So everyone here receive one of these forms. And Brother Michael, if I could have one of those as well to make sure I'm sharing the right information. I need you to get your pens out. Ladies, if you have more than one that you could share with people around you, I need you to get those out. And we want to do this just as quickly as we can so that we can move right along and get into the prizes. This is our survey form. Now, if you filled one out during the survey, then you do not have to fill it all out. We need your name and, let's say, a phone number or birth date that will identify you specifically in case we have two people with the same name here tonight. Now, here's another stipulation. You must print very legibly. We have to be able to read your name. I'm not going to say who said it, but I heard that if they can't read your name, you can't win the prize. I'm teasing. We will use every power of interpretation possible. But please print it very clearly. And again, we don't need you to fill out everything if you've already done it. But if you are tonight seeing this form for the first time, would you do us a favor and go ahead and fill it out completely? Just as quickly as you're able to do so. Still need some forms up front. Ushers, we still need... Oh, they're coming. They're coming from the back forward on that side. What I need you to do is make sure you fill out that information, and I need a name and a birth date or a name and a phone number for the majority of you because you participated in the survey month. If you did not, and you can go ahead and give us the rest of the information, we would greatly appreciate that. Now, all the prizes are going to be available. We're going to let the children win on behalf of families and so forth here tonight so we don't have to slow down and gauge things, with the exception of the trip to Israel. There is an age minimum on that trip. And Pastor, is that 18 years? 18 years old or above. And of course, you know that'll require going and getting your passport and so forth. And you have plenty of time to get all that done. It's going to be a great trip for someone. I'm telling you, life-changing and such a blast. No one, I'll tell you, there's no one greater to go to Israel with than Pastor Bob and Margaret. They've been nearly 40 times or more, and believe me, they know what they're doing, and they take you to all the great places, a lot of places others don't get to go. So you're going to be blessed with that trip. All right, so I'm going to let you get this form filled out. We want to make sure, again, for most of you, just your name and either your birth date or a phone number so we can distinguish you from someone else that may have a similar name in case that were to happen. In fact, since there is going to be an age requirement for Israel, go ahead and put your birth date on there. Go ahead and put your birth date on there. We're not going to reveal, ladies, that. It's all confidential. All right, how many still need a moment to get your form filled out? All right, again, for most of you, your name and your birth date is all we need. If you've already done this before during the month of February or the first week of March, only if you have not done this do you need to fill it all out. Okay, ushers, if you'll go ahead and get ready with some buckets, and we're going to have you to collect these. Or maybe it'd be easier just to have everyone pass them to the aisle. That's what we'll do. You can just collect them that way. All right, let's go ahead and start doing that. Pass them to the nearest aisle. We want to thank those that have contributed to the gifts and prizes tonight. We have a number of people within our church that have given from their businesses, either products or service certificates. There's a lot of great dinners up here, a lot of special things that'll help you, and whether it's auto care, housekeeping, whatever it might be. We've got some unique things. Here is a diaper cake, one of the ladies here. So, you know, the last time we gave one of these away, the person that won it actually had a family member that was soon to have a baby. So that's maybe the same thing will happen tonight. Yeah, there's a lot of intercession going on there. Well, while we get all the forms collected, I'd like to introduce the folks that really made this happen. Pastor Dave Keeling leads our pastoral care department with a host of district pastors, and they went out, they did all the legwork, made all the contacts, and did an incredible job of gathering these items. And so Pastor Dave's going to come, and he's going to take it from this point forward. Let's give them all a good hand.
Amen. Praise the Lord. All right, are you ready to win tonight? Come on, who's ready to win? Who wants to win some of these prizes over here?
We'll go ahead and start loading those up in the hopper.
All the evangel business people who've donated, come on.
Yeah, make sure also if you have filled out a form and you haven't gotten it up here, now is your opportunity. Make sure you come and get it in at this very moment. All right, praise the Lord. All right, I'm going to ask everybody to stand. All right, move around a little bit. All right, praise the Lord. All right. All right. Now put your hand over your heart. All right. Say, dear Lord, I refuse to get mad, upset, or hold a grudge against Pastor David if he does not draw my name. But please, Lord, let him draw my name. Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a big praise clap. Amen, amen, amen. All right, you may be seated. Pastor Monica, what do we have?
Okay. You know what? This is my favorite night because I think this is our biggest prayer meeting of the entire year right here because everybody's praying that they're going to win, right? Right. Okay, guess what, you all? We're doing something kind of new this year. How many of y'all remember the Shepherd's Guide? Remember that? Raise your hand. Okay, we have business people here at Evangel that we need to keep it in the family. If you've got a business or a service that you offer, we need to know about it. And this is an avenue, a vehicle that you guys are going to learn about some business owners. And so we need to use our people. We need to help each other prosper. So that's something we're going to do tonight. And each of you are going to be hitting each other going, why aren't you up there? You should be up there too. So, okay, we're going to start with Carol Powell. Wait a minute. Are we ready with some names?
We are ready.
Okay. Carol.
All right.
Is an artist. She does, this is a print. It's upstairs. She's going to give it to the winner. And she also does a service where it's called Create and Take. You can have a birthday party. You can have a bunch of kids over, or you can have a women's group of some sort together, and you all can paint a picture. She'll teach you how to paint a picture, and she does it. It's called Create and Take. There you go. Let's have a name.
And the winner is Linda Samples. Where are you? There she is. All right, let's give her a big praise clap.
Okay, this is JP Roofing and Modeling. They will do anything. Anything you need in your home, they will do it. They will do it, and they will do an excellent job at it, too.
And who's going to take home this prize? It's Mary Vance. All right, there she is.
This is Carol Purvis. Guess what she does? She has a creative designs. Here, Carol. And she does these wonderful diapers. This one has is $35, and it has a whole bunch of diapers in it. Okay.
All right. And the winner is Sophia Crowder. Where are you, Sophia? All right, there you go.
Okay, this is Dee Freeman. And Dee Freeman has a couple of different things she does. She does, let's do the photography first. Dee does photography. It's outstanding photography. She will do a setting for just yourself or a whole group of people. She'll do like 200 prints, and you can choose which ones you want. This is a $200 value.
And this is going to Carol Purvis. All right. She didn't have to go far.
Leslie Bowles. They have a company called Main Street Advertising. No, insurance. Okay, and so they have it's an insurance company where you're not going to be talking to somebody in India. You'll be talking to a real person, and he knows your name. Okay, so this, what he's giving away is a $450 value for all kinds of automoto repair.
All right, and who's going to take this home with them? None other than Leo Simon. Come on down, Leo. All right.
And this is our beautiful Veronica Bryant. Yeah. And she's been selling Mary Kay for 6 years. And so we'd like to give this away to a willing person.
Well, let's see who this is going to be. And we're going to award this to Charles Lanter. Charles, come on down. Use that well.
Okay, this is Roshonda Overton. She has a wonderful basket. I mean, this is so nice. This is... from Arbonne. It's a spa, wonderful spa package worth $160. Now who wants this? She sells Arbonne, and she will do a party at your home, and you will be blessed by doing it.
And the winner is Wilson Batuma. All right, back over here. You know, the guys have a heavy anointing on them tonight to win.
Seen her. She's the only one in the world with a car, with a van painted like Starry, Starry Night. She does face paintings for birthday parties, and she does handcrafted jewelry. This is a lovely piece that she does all by herself, and you can see an example of some of her painting. Okay, let's have a name here.
All right, we're going to try to do as best we can here today, and it's Ricky A. Harvar. Ricky A.
Ricky A, come on down.
Come on, where are you?
Okay, going.
All right.
Going. He really wants this. This guy really
wants this. This one is Ricky A.
Let's give it to him just because he wants it so bad.
Okay.
Dr. Chris Leneve, and he is offering a $100 gift certificate of anything you want done. Anything you want done. You can do whitening or anything, right? Dr. Chris Leneve, a great dental practice.
Well, this person doesn't have to go very far at all to receive, and it's George Pantoja. Right here. There you go. Right there. All right. All right.
Jimmy Isaacs, you're not here, are you? Okay, Gloria, we're going to have Gloria represent Jimmy Isaacs. He does a great painting. Somehow the rooms don't smell after they're painted. I don't know. Real soon afterwards. They don't even smell like paint. Okay, he's giving away a free room to be painted.
And the winner is Shirley Barnes. Where are you, Shirley? All right, congratulations.
Okay, since he isn't here, I'd like to recognize Steve Hopkins. Steve Hopkins, where are you? He does painting too, and he's donated so many times. Okay, this is Billy. Billy has a cleaning service. She does a wonderful, wonderful job. She's given away a $210 house cleaning. There you go. You all need to call these people and let them clean your house or paint you a picture or insure your car. And who do we have for this?
It is Dustin Vernon. Where are you? Is it Vernon Nissette? All right over here.
Yay.
All right.
Yay,
come on, let's give him a big hand as he comes down and collects his prize.
Okay, we have JP Roofing. We're going to do another one. $200. And he will do anything. He will do anything for your home. He will put on a roof. He won't clean your house. He will remodel your home, a bathroom, kitchen.
All right, let's see who's going to get this service. And it's going to be Doris Barnett. How are you, Doris? All right, there you go.
Robin McKnight sells these, and you can start your own business with this. It barely costs anything. These are so cool. You burn a candle, and you get jewelry in there, too. They burn for 120 hours. Cherise, will you give this out to the winner? This is Robin McKnight, Pastor McKnight's lovely wife.
All right, and this is going to a very dear, wonderful sister in the Lord, none other than Miss Joyce Blankenship. Come on, let's give the Lord a big praise. She was just in the hospital last week. God's raised her up. Amen. We're so proud of you, Joyce. God bless you.
Okay, what next we are doing Tom Bowles, Main Street Insurance. This is Michael's Tires. They $450 worth of maintenance.
All right, and who's going to take this with him? It's none other than Lisa Thompson. Where are you, Lisa? Come and collect your prize. There she is. All right, congratulations.
Okay, Freddie White, come on down. Freddie White, he does concrete work, but you know, he couldn't bring in a driveway or anything like that. So he has a gift certificate he's gonna give to somebody. Any type of concrete work. How many of y'all knew Freddie did this? Did you know that? No. Everybody's shaking their head, Freddie. Nobody knew. Now they'll know, okay?
All right, let's look around and let's look for Micah Paulson. Where are you, Micah? All right. There he is. Hallelujah. Come on, let's see some enthusiasm here tonight.
Hey!
Amen. Come on, some excitement in the house.
Okay, carpet cleaning from Billy Hayes, grand finale. Carpet cleaning. How many of y'all knew that? She does this. Okay, $300.
All right, now, how many of you ever saw The Price is Right? Now, when they call your name, they don't just kind of droop up there, do they? I mean, they are ecstatic in excitement. So we call your name. I want you to act like a winner tonight. Amen? All right. And our winner is Don Peterson. Come on, Don. There you go. Come on, let's give it up for Don. Well.
It's for men and women.
Men and women.
Right.
Well, this completes a husband and wife duo winner tonight, and that's none other than Kathy Simon. Come on, Miss Kathy.
Okay, Chris Lanee. Dr. Chris, come on down. Another $100 gift certificate to Lanee Dental for any service that you would like. Everybody smile real pretty. The one with the prettiest smile gets it.
All right. Our winner is Jacob Swan. Where are you, Jacob? All right, let's give Jacob a big hand.
Okay, this is another of Carol's creations. This is 114 diapers in here. Is this not cool? This is very, very cool. All you need is a baby to give it to. So creative. So if you need something creative done, you call Carol.
All right. Our next winner is Helen Saunders. Where are you, Helen? Come on. God healed her tonight, and she won a prize. Hallelujah. All right, who is going to be our winner? And it is Debbie Bailey. Where are you, Debbie?
Okay,
right so over here, Debbie. Hallelujah.
Just contact Dee, and she'll let you know how you can get one of those too. Okay, we have a 1 month unlimited sessions from William Klingelsmith. He doesn't seem to be here. And it's 1 month, it's $59. What they do is they're Israeli self-defense there.
All right. You're going to be able to protect your husband, Cassandra Dumbo. All right. There's another wife that's going to be able to protect her husband. And it's none other than Lisa Jones.
Yay, Lisa!
Come on, Lisa.
Okay, thank you, Evangel Business People. You all did a wonderful job. Thank you very, very much. Okay, we have Fraser History Museum. Four tickets. For $42 value, and also a restaurant, Las Azetas.
All right, and our winner is Corey Peek.
Hey,
where are
Corey.
You? Where are you? All right.
Okay.
Are you still here? They're pointing to the back.
Okay.
All right, they must come very quickly or they forfeit.
Okay, next.
All right.
We have Marlisa's Place. It's a $20 gift card. They do cupcakes and cookies, Mango's Grill, and also Chick-fil-A nuggets and sandwiches.
All right. Donnie Whitlock. Where are you, Donnie? Right over here. Come on, let's give him a big clap. Amen. Congratulations, Donnie.
Okay, we have a Brush of Excellence, Texas Roadhouse, and Taco Bell. Texas Roadhouse is a dinner for two for $30.
All right. And let's see who's going to get to enjoy that. And it's David Twyman. Come on.
Next, we have Creation Museum. Two free tickets. And on your way home, you can go to the Melting Pot in Lexington.
All right. That sounds like a great time. And let's see who gets to enjoy that. None other than Freddie White.
Hey, Freddie.
Come on, Freddie. wife is really getting excited.
Okay, next we have a manicure, restaurant tickets at Mango's Grill, and a coupon for Sweet Savannah's yogurt.
All right. You want to know who gets to take that with them? That's not enough. Who wants to know? All right. It's Alicia Polson. All right. All right, congratulations.
Okay, next we have Cart Country. Who'd like to go to Cart Country? And Backwoods Smoke and Grill, and also get your hair done at Rush of Excellence.
All right. This is going to fit perfectly for David Patrick. Where are you at, David? There you go. Come on, Dave.
Okay, Emic Car Practice. Chiropractic. You get an exam and x-rays. It's a $200 value.
All right. How many want to win that? Well, Cynthia, lift your hand a little bit higher because you just won.
Yay!
Come on. Hallelujah.
Okay, this is a package from WJIE. It's got a couple of mugs in it. It's got tickets to Phillips, Craig, and Dean. And it's got some CDs in it.
All right. And the winner is Dante Murray. All right, where are you? Right over here. All right, congratulations. There you go. I like that. He's jogging on down here. Congratulations.
This is another jewelry and a candle. This is from Dee Freeman.
All right, we're trying to get the interpretation on this one right here. Let's collaborate a little bit.
This is our resident Vanna. Y'all having fun? Who's having fun? Okay.
Is there a Kate Selconde or something close? I apologize if I butchered your name, Kate. All right, please forgive me. All right, congratulations. All right, and who gets to enjoy that? None other than Billy G. Price. Come on, Billy, where are you? All right. All right. Congratulations.
Okay, you get to go to, somebody gets to have a pedicure, go to Texas Roadhouse later on in the day, and get your car fixed at Valvoline later on, the next day, maybe.
I'm pleased to be able to announce that that is going to go to Ronnie Hack. Ronnie, come on down. All right, you know, Ronnie's wife, Debbie's been in the hospital this past week. I'm so glad to see him win this. Amen. We love you, Ronnie.
Okay. There's a $25 gift certificate for Salon 4300, Bistro 42. This bag, it's got two YMCA t-shirts in it. And Anigo's Restaurant. That's an Italian restaurant. Is that good?
All right. Who wants to take that with you? All right. Who gets to enjoy that is? All right. Amen. Vance Alves. Right here. Okay.
Gets to have a flat repair. Hope you don't have one, but if you do, you get a flat repair from Big O Tires, Backwoods Smoke and Grill, and Mango's Grill. You can go grilling after your flat tire.
All right. Who's looking forward to doing some grilling? All right. This is a wonderful lady, and her name is Rebecca Woods.
All right.
All right. There she is.
Pizza place before that, and then you can go get frozen yogurt at Sweet Savannah's.
Roger Weber. Come and claim your prize. Oh, there we go. Congratulations, Roger.
Okay, I've got a jewelry and a candle. These are from Robin McKnight and Dee Freeman. This is, you can also get your haircut first and go to Goose Creek Diner.
All right, and we've got Amon Rush. Where are you? All right, congratulations.
This one's heavy. This is an AutoZone cleaning bucket. Got a ton of stuff in here to clean your car. You're far stronger than me.
And the winner is Janice Groupie, who doesn't own a car. Congratulations, Janice.
Okay, this is cool. This is Marengo Cave. It's a walking tour for two, $29 value. On your way, you can go to Backwoods Smoke and Grill and then go get a frozen yogurt at Sweet Savannah's.
Brandon Petoya. All right. You can treat mom and dad.
Okay. This is from Tom Bowles, Main Street Insurance. This is from Michael's Tires. And you can go get your haircut at the Outer Loop Barber Shop and get a Culver's basket. And there's a $5 Chili's coupon in there, too. Bunch of stuff.
All right. And the person that gets to take this home is Sean Nossett. Where are you, Sean? All right, back over here.
Okay, we have a $15 certificate to Goose Creek Diner, Mango's Grill, Backroads Grill, Backwoods Grill, and Chick-fil-A Nuggets. We're gonna fatten you up.
All right, Melanie Wagner, come on down and claim your prize. Come on, let's give it up for Melanie. There she is right there. I hope you enjoy that.
Okay, we've got some McAllister's. You get a free meal. You get a quick lube at Valvoline and Chick-fil-A. Nuggets and a sandwich.
And this goes to one of our favorite and most loyal ushers, and they're all favorite and loyal, Russell Pretty.
Hey,
come on down, Russell.
Certificates to Gaddy's in Shepherdsville. They are big supporters of Evangel and big supporters of this event. So we've got tons of those in these coupons too. Outer Loop Barbershop, you get a haircut. You can go get your, this is from Tom Bowles again. $450 worth of coupons. And this is a buns place. It's a hamburger place and Mango's Grill.
All right. Miss Carolyn Newland, you get to take this with you. All right, congratulations, Carolyn.
Okay, this is a big, huge cookie.
All right, who wants to win that tonight?
If the winner is really nice, you'll cut it up and share.
Oh, okay. How many of you have sweet tooth? All right.
You also get, you can get your hair done at a Brush of Excellence, and you get McAllister's a free meal.
All right, and the person that gets to indulge in this is Carol Powell. All right, Carol. Where are you? Right over there. Enjoy that.
Boy, it's interesting how these business owners are getting blessed. A lot of these are getting their names called. Okay, this is for William Klinglesmith, or from him. This is Crab Manga. It's a crash course in Israeli defense. It's a $295 value.
And we're going to follow in the same suit and award this to Tom Bowles.
Yeah.
Come on down, Tom.
Mango's Grill. You can eat fast food all week long.
All right. And the winner is Ryan Mosley. Congratulations, Ryan. All right, appreciate you.
This is jewelry and a candle from Robin McKnight and Dee Freeman. This is, but you also get Renew with Jill. This is a $185 value. It's a 60-minute facial.
And the winner is Mark Weird. Now, Mark, after you go and have all that done, we want you to come back and testify.
Okay, this is from a Family Christian Store right there at the Outer Loop. It's an umbrella, some music videos, and a Courageous DVD. And now you'll probably need that umbrella tonight.
All right, we're trying to interpret some of these. But it looks like the last name is Bell. Looks like C is the initial for the first, for the last name, for the first name. C Bell. Is there a C Bell in here?
Taco Bell?
Right here? Close enough. You're the winner.
Yay! Okay, this is for a gentleman. This is a gentleman's candle. And it even has some kind of jewelry for a man. This is, you also can get your hair cut at Outer Loop Barbershop. You get a oil change at Goodyear and a wonderful candle.
All right, everybody stand up just for a moment. Turn to the person next to you and give them a high five and say, you're next. All right, you may be seated. And the person that is next is Charles Berry. All right, Charles.
Oh, good. Man won it.
Congratulations. Chuck.
Okay, y'all having fun? Okay, Lost River Cave. This is an underground boat tour. This for $31, a backwoods smoking grill, and you can get your hair done at Brush of Excellence beforehand.
Well, this particular winner can have a husband and wife fellowship all day with all that they've won, and it goes to Tammy Weir. There you go. Come on, Tammy, celebrate a little bit. There you go.
Okay, Ken Towery's. You get a free oil change, Chick-fil-A coupons, Sweet Savannah, and a Culver's basket.
Oh, and it's my honor to announce the winner of this as Sister Barbara Perdue. Come on, Sister Barbara, where are you?
She's upstairs counting.
She's upstairs counting
and
the
she's
offering.
She's not here right now. She's upstairs counting.
She's upstairs counting offering. Now, do we give her that prize?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. Amen. We'll hold that prize for her.
Okay, this is a DQ, an 8-inch frozen cake. Leslie, where's Tom? Tom would probably want that for his birthday this year. Pizza Place, a $10 gift certificate, Bistro 42, and Sweet Savannah's frozen yogurt.
And the person that gets to enjoy that is Gary Gabbard. Congratulations, Gary. All right, here he comes. There you go. That's what I like to see, some enthusiasm about our winners. Good job, Gary.
Restaurant, a $25 gift certificate, and a free haircut at Caribbean Sun.
And that goes to Ginger Mador. All right, congratulations, Ginger.
Okay, Kentucky Derby Museum, two tickets, and Los Azetes Restaurant. It's a Mexican restaurant right downtown. You can do them both.
Come on down, Armand Johnson, and claim your prize. Where are you? Right over here. Congratulations.
Okay, we have another Crab Fit, a 1-month unlimited session. You can go there and work out till you get tired. You can go to Angio's Italian restaurant and give yourself something to work out on.
All right. And that's going to go to Keelan Jones. Where are you? All right. Let's give our winner a real big round. Hand of applause. Amen.
Okay, I've got a Y bag with a t-shirt in it, Ultra 10, a gift certificate, and free nuggets and a sandwich from Chick-fil-A.
And that's going to go to Charles Bell. Where are you, Charles? All right.
Okay, you can get your windows cleaned. Do some spring cleaning. This is from Billy Hayes and Grand Finale. $200 value. Clean your windows and jewelry and a candle. You can relax. You don't have to clean your windows.
Kamari Williams, you get to enjoy that gift. All right. Congratulations, sweetheart.
Congratulations. Okay, we have a Denny's Classic Diner gift certificate, Exhaust Pro, Blackwood Smoking Grill, and Mango's Grill.
And that gets to go to Curtis. Curtis, where are you, Curtis? All right. Come on now. There you go.
Now you all have to know that all these people are donating because they want their name out here. They want your business. That's why these people are donating. And so that's why we want you all to frequent these businesses. Bless them for blessing us. Okay, you can go to the Thomas Edison House. Take four people with you. You can go to the cafe. It's a cool place, cool new place. And the Goose Creek Diner, you can go there the next day.
All right, and the recipient is Hiram Cornett. Come on down, Hiram. I saw you, there you are.
Okay, how many of you all know that Kentucky Kingdom is reopening? I've got four free tickets for a day for their $45 each.
How many wants to win that? And the winner is Silas Johnson. Look at that. Oh, isn't that wonderful? All right, congratulations.
Does anybody have an iPhone? Oh, I got an iPhone repair. iPhone repair. If you've got a cracked screen or anything like that, you can get an oil change. You can go to Chick-fil-A and get a nugget, and then go to Beer Nose.
All right, sounds like a great day.
You'll get your iPhone repaired.
There you go. Nyla Buck. Congratulations, Nyla.
Hey, Nyla!
All right.
Nyla, we know your name. Okay, I've got a Y bag with a t-shirt in it, Mark's Feed Store. After you go there, you really need to go to the Y. Blackwood Smoking Grill, Jerry's J-Boy, and there you go.
And the winner is Jerry Rogers. All right, Jerry, come on down.
Okay, this is for a gentleman to give to his wife. This is Lloyd's Florist. Want to give a dozen roses to your wife? You can do it free. You can get your hair cut first so you look good. And go to Sweet Savannah Yogurt. You can take her to get a frozen yogurt.
Well, I am honored to be able to announce the winner of that is Ira Brierly.
Hey!
All right. Come on, Miss Karen. Let's get a little excited. There you go.
Karen deserves that, Ira. Okay, Mango's Grill, $10 gift certificate. Pizza Place, $10 gift certificate. Goose Creek Diner. And Big O Tires, free rotate and balance.
And this goes to one of our other most loved and appreciated ushers, Bob Bayline. Come on down. Let's let him know we appreciate it.
Okay, Kentucky Horse Park. We got a family pack of four tickets. It's a $64 value. Pizza Place for $15. And also a ton of gift certificates. certificates for Gaddy's Restaurant in Shelbyville.
All right, and the individual that gets to take this home and enjoy this is Debbie Haynes. All right, Debbie, congratulations. All right.
Hey, Debbie. Okay, I've got a Outer Loop Barber Shop, Michael's Tires. This is from Tom Bowles, and Main Street Insurance, and also a $10 gift certificate for a pizza place.
All right. Are you ready? William Garrett.
William Garrett, come on down.
All right, William. Congratulations.
Okay. You get a free haircut at Caribbean Sun, Denny's Classic Diner, $10, Mango's Grill, and go to get a yogurt at Sweet Savannah's.
All right. And our winner is Donna Iskrig. All right, congratulations, Donna.
Okay, this is a jewelry and a candle, and you can go to Alliance Chiropractic and get an exam and x-rays, $175 value. And then you can go to Mango Cantina and eat.
And our winner is Herbert Thompson. Congratulations, Brother Herbert.
Okay, we've got the Metzger Park Zoo in Evansville. Sounds like a nice day trip. You've got 4 free tickets, Bun's Restaurant, a hamburger place, and Sweet Savannah frozen yogurt.
All right.
We're down to 2.
All right, and the winner is Miss Miriam.
Wait a minute.
Where are you?
Wait a minute. It's the Louisville Zoo. Louisville Zoo. 2 free tickets. It's a $32 value. Oh, did you not do that one yet?
No.
I'm sorry.
Oh. You got ahead of me. Calm down.
Sorry.
Pull back on the reins. Okay.
Whoa.
All right. Miss did she leave? Okay. Wah, wah, wah. Okay. Monet Murray.
Hey, Monet.
Where are you? All right.
Okay, now let's do the Louisville Zoo. 2 free tickets, $32 value, and Pizza Place gift certificate.
All right, and it is none other than Linda Wilcox. There you go. That's what we want to see.
What we like to see. Okay. I think this is it. This is it before the big grand prize. This is jewelry and a candle from Robin McKnight. This is Fantastic Sam's. You get a shampoo and a conditioner. You go buy the shampoo and conditioner, and you can get your hair cut at another place called Brush of Excellence.
Daniel Contrell. All right. Now we have our grand prize. Oh, come on, say woo! Come on, stir up the enthusiasm here tonight. Now they're going to take all of these, place them in the hopper, along, get all the other ones over there, place them in the hopper. And at this time, let's give the Lord a big praise clap for our pastor, Pastor Bob, Pastor Margaret. Why don't you come at this time? And we're going to give away our grand prize trip tonight, and it's going to be to Israel.
Trip to Israel is going to be a trip of a lifetime. And every time I've gone to Israel, God's spoken to me, And when you go, God's going to speak to you. But it's just going to be a first-class trip. We're going to stay at five-star hotels. We'll arrive in Tel Aviv. And then we will drive down through Nazareth all the way down to Galilee. And your first night will be along the Sea of Galilee. You'll be able to walk out your hotel and go down and touch the water. There are some shopping places there. And then the next morning, we'll get in a boat and we'll go out on the Sea of Galilee and stop right in the middle of that body of water and have a service.
And you know the lady who won this last year is sitting right there, and we just took her to Israel. Vonda. Come tell everybody how awesome that trip really is.
It's unbelievable. It changes your life. When you get off the plane, you feel like you have come home, and you won't be the same. I have not been the same since I've come back. Not been the same. Thank you all so much.
Did you like the food over there?
Oh, the food is unbelievable. You've never eaten food like that before in your life. The flavor and the taste, it's fabulous. You can't eat the food hardly when you come back here.
And you know, in Jericho, there was a sheikh that came and he offered 35 camels for Vonda. But we said, no, that's not enough. Hallelujah. Come on, give Vonda a great big hand. Praise God.
She was awesome, and our trip was awesome. And whoever's going to get this trip, where are you anyway? Well, it will be the trip of your lifetime, I promise.
All right, they're drawing now. Every head bowed. Everyone praying. Are you ready? Are you prayed up? Is your tithe paid up? Hallelujah. The winner is someone that we have known for a long time, a very deserving person, and someone we love very much. And Margaret, announced who that winner is.
He's been active in this church too as an usher. Roger Weber.
Praise the Lord, Roger.
I'm speechless. I was getting ready to leave. I knew I was going. Well, praise God. Thank you. That's all I can say. Thank you.
Amen. Come on, give me a great big hand. Hallelujah. Well, maybe you go. Well, this was great, wasn't it? Well, we're going to go out here with a shout tonight. Everybody had a great time. On the count of three. One, two, three. Jesus! 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 Amen.